What do you do if you're an advanced enthusiast and you like lots of controls and point-and-shoot size cameras, but you like the image quality that comes from larger sensors and changeable lens cameras? Well, here's a nice little option. It's the Panasonic Lumix DMC GM1. Hi, I'm Larry Becker. You know, mirrorless cameras hit the photography market a few years back, and one of the most established groups of mirrorless cameras is the Panasonic and Olympus Micro Four Thirds mount cameras. There's a nice collection of lenses out there, and the Panasonic Four Thirds image sensor is more than four times the physical size of common 1/1.7-inch sensors found in many point-and-shoot cameras. The 16-megapixel LiveMOS 4/3 sensor in this camera has a native ISO range of 200 to 25,600, and that low end is expandable down to 125. The especially small GM1 body still has direct controls for a number of things like focus mode via the switch on top, a shooting mode dial, a joystick-style control dial with built-in buttons, a dedicated movie record button, a quick menu button, a programmable FN or function button, a display button, and even a slider to make the flash pop up. And while the 3-inch 1.036 million dot LCD screen doesn't move, it's a touch screen, and that gives you quick access to all kinds of controls and adjustments. Some touch screens I've used have been limited, but this touch screen lets you do everything from selecting menus to full swipe and zoom during image playback. And of course, you can touch to select a focus point, or you can even turn on touch shutter. And a quick word about this camera's touch shutter, it's fast. In spite of the small size and relatively lightweight, there's good, sturdy build quality with a magnesium alloy body. The only ergonomic downside for me is the lack of any grip shape on the face of the camera. I like the idea of Panasonic's optional DMW HGR1 grip plate, and if something like that still fits in your gear budget, grab it. On the other hand, if you'd like to spend under 10 bucks and still add an ergonomic grip shape to the front of your camera, there's an accessory I reviewed during the 2013 holiday season called a Flipback G3. Personally, I wouldn't use this camera very much without a grip or a wrist strap because, probably like most people, I just use two fingers and a thumb to hold it. The images the GM1 captures are really good, especially if you're used to cell phone or point-and-shoot camera pictures. This is one of a couple of cameras I was able to test while shooting after sunset at the Neon Museum in Las Vegas recently. I shot some f3.5 images at ISO 3200, and I was surprised how good the images looked. Maybe I was expecting point-and-shoot quality, but these images were much more like what I'd get from a modern APS-C size sensor. During the day, with lower ISO numbers and faster shutter speeds, the images are great. I used a couple of lenses on the GM1, including the newly released kit lens that ships with this camera. It's a 12-32mm f3.5-5.6, which, with the 2x crop factor of the 4/3 sensor, is a 24-64mm equivalent. So the zoom range works well for a good variety of shooting, and when you dial the lens to its storage position, it's surprisingly small. It's pocketable if you have a decent-sized jacket pocket. I like that there's no lock button on the lens to slow you down, but since you do have to dial the lens to the 12mm position from its storage position in order to start shooting, it does slow down that first snap just a little bit. After that, though, the camera is surprisingly responsive. In moderate to bright light, the focus is fast. Even in dim conditions, when it has to hunt back and forth a little, it's still pretty darn quick. Even without a focusing ring, you can manually focus this lens. You set the focus mode switch to manual, then use the control dial or an on-screen slider to change focus. Manual focus is helped by a zoom panel and focus peaking, but I still found it less than quick, and I don't see myself using digital manual focus very much at all. On the other hand, I was able to test Panasonic's Leica Prime 25mm f1.4 lens with a focus ring, and the manual focus was much more natural. Of course, it's an autofocus lens, and that shallow depth of field the wide aperture enables is great. And since it's a nano-coated lens, flare and ghosting should be kept to a minimum. Obviously, this is much more than a simple point-and-shoot camera with changeable lenses. Sure, it can act like a point-and-shoot, and amateurs can easily use it with the mode dial set to one of the automatic modes. Now, besides Intelligent Auto, there's an Intelligent Auto Plus that lets users adjust brightness and hue while still doing everything automatically. There's a scene mode that lets you tell the camera about the shooting environment so that everything is set for that kind of shoot. And there's a creative control mode that applies various special effects, and it lets you see them before you snap the shutter. Then, for the more skilled user, there's programmed auto, shutter priority, aperture priority, manual, and even a couple of programmable positions labeled C1 and C2. And while you can record video from any position of the mode dial by just pressing the record button, there's a mode dial position called Creative Video Mode that lets you adjust the aperture, shutter speed, ISO, and mic volume manually. And I was pleasantly surprised to find out that all of those variables can even be changed during filming. And it's really nice that you can record MP4 or AVCHD files. Since we're talking about video, I'll tell you that the quality is good, but pro videographers probably won't be using the GM1 in spite of the manual controls. That's because there are no mic or headphone jacks, and the max 1080p frame rate is 30. It does 1080 60i though. Then again, when sound isn't a factor, you've got some great options. If you're doing time-lapse videos, there's a built-in interval timer. Also, there's a shooting mode that lets you shoot frame by frame, and it saves the image into a video file, so you can do stop-motion videos straight from your camera. Here are a few more things advanced shooters will like. The pop-up flash is one of those spring-loaded, tiltable pop-up flashes, so you can angle it back and bounce light off the ceiling. Even with that in mind, low-light flash photography is not a strong suit with the GM1. The flash sync speed is 1/50th of a second, and there's no hot shoe to add another flash. Earlier I mentioned that there's a programmable function button. Now, it's on top of the camera at the center of the focus mode switch, and you can set that button to do whatever you want. By default, it's set to turn on Wi-Fi communication that's built into the GM1. And there's also touchscreen access to even more programmable functions. And that Wi-Fi functionality allows for remote shooting of stills or video using the free Panasonic Image app. You can also print wirelessly, upload images to web services via Panasonic's Lumix Club, and you can even send images to a PC or a television. I really like that the Wi-Fi-based remote control shooting allows you to control things like white balance, focus point, aperture, and shutter speed, and you can do all that remotely. It even does touch shutter remotely, but it's not quick like the camera-based touch shutter is. If you're interested in this camera, I'd recommend downloading a PDF of the manual. That's because there are functions and features that just can't be covered in this or really any review. For example, there are quite a few scene guide mode options, including clear portrait, silky skin, glistening water, glittering illuminations, and that's, by the way, a star bokeh filter. There's artistic nightscape and cute dessert, among others. My point is that there are quite a few unique settings. Another thing that really requires the manual for people to understand is the burst mode. Now, there are quite a few options, and there are trade-offs for each of those options, like the fact that it'll shoot up to 40 frames a second, but the maximum number of shots is 39. Then, if you decide to shoot 10 frames a second, it can do that, but it slows down after the buffer fills up. And there are various file size limitations based on your burst rate. The Panasonic Lumix DMC GM1 is one of the smallest mirrorless cameras out there. And with the respectable collection of Micro Four Thirds lenses available, not to mention the nice compact kit lens that comes with the GM1, as well as the 4/3 size sensor, image quality and performance will definitely be a step up from point-and-shoot cameras. For B&H and Kelby One, I'm Larry Becker. Thanks for watching.
Whether you're a hobbyist or a professional, B&H has the answers to your questions. Experience a world of technology at our New York City Superstore. Connect with us online or give us a call. Our staff of experts is happy to help.
Scott Kelby here, and welcome to this quick tour of our online training. We have hundreds of online classes for you, covering everything from lighting to landscape photography. From portrait photography to sports, we have classes on wedding, automotive photography, shooting, food, fashion, travel, you name it. The most incredible part of this is the price. You get all of this for just $199 a year, or you can pay monthly for just $24.95. 24-hour a day, 7-day a week access from anywhere in the world. I invite you to join with us today and start learning right now.